ลงอยู่ record already
ครับ
นะฮะโอเคเลยเริ่มสตาร์ท
โอเค good morning everyone our group JST group the first member is my Kalawut Kama Wong and the next is Sakan Termkel and the last is Viparat Wadapit Pong. Today we would like to talk about an iterative method and its application to stable inversion. This is the outline. Further introduction and preliminary we'll talk by Viparat and section 2 and T convergent analysis and data dependency we'll talk by Sakan Termkel and the last the application to stable inversion we'll talk by me.
For the first section introduce and preliminary. In this paper, the author their convergent and they study convergent and data dependence of SK iterative method and normal iterative method for the class of all-mode contraction mapping under some mild condition. The validity of this theoretical result is confirmed with numerical example. They put that this iterative method are equivalent when converging to the same fixed point of the operator. And they also have a version of the SP iterative method with soon S and normal S iterative method. Finally, an application of normal S iterative method to stable version of this the mechanical system is presented in the T-card languages. This is offered with a numerical example. Throughout the paper, S is a closed and convex subset of a Banach space D. T is an operator mapping S to S, and the symbol FT denotes the set of the point of T. And sequence beta in I as a set of set 01 are the real sequence satisfied certain contribution. The Zuno iterative method is defined like this equation. This iterative method leads you to the well-known such as Ishikawa, Mann, Picard, and normal S iterative method. We can see in remark that it looks like the Ishikawa iterative method if beta n3 equal to 0. For Mann iterative method if beta n2 and beta n3 equal to 0. For Picard iterative method if beta n1 equal to 1 and beta n2 and beta n3 equal to 0. For normal S iterative method, if beta n1 equal to 1 and beta n3 equal to 0. Next, consider a class of operator satisfy the following inequality, where the epsilon greater than or equal to 0 and delta in this interval. This equation number 2 we will use many times in paper. And next, oscillate establish stability of Mann, Ishikawa, and Kirk iterative method for this part of the operator. It is worth noting that contractive condition number 2 is not sufficient to guarantee the existence of its point of the operator T. It's defined like this. Constitute an example to this negative claim. In order to guarantee the existence of fixed point of the operator satisfy condition 2. Belinda making a small but subtle modification of condition 2 and has introduced to so-called almost contractive operator satisfy the following contractive type condition where the same epsilon and delta. The equation 2 are different with equation 3 only this part. From equation 2 we have norm A minus TA, equation T norm A prime minus TA. And Belinda, he also showed that this class of nonlinear operator is wider than the class of well-known Semfeld-Olem operator. And an operator T satisfied both condition 2 and 3 has a unique fixed point. In 2005, Belinda used the Ishikawa iterative method to approximate the fixed point of the operator satisfying contractive condition number 2 in a non-space setting. More precisely, he proved the following theorem. The theorem 1.1, let B be a nonlinear space, S a closed and convex subset of B, and T an operator with fixed point T not in this set, satisfy equation 2. Let sequence X N be the Ishikawa iterative method with the sequence beta N1 in closed interval 0, 1. Satisfy this condition. Then the sequence xn converges strongly to the unique fixed point of T. Recently, Sinthu Navarat and Pitya introduced the following iterative method. It looks like SUNO, but it's different from SUNO. This iterative method will be called SP iterative method, and is independent from SUNO, Ishikawa and Mann iterative method. However, it's induced to the well-known Picard normal S and S iterative method by Picard iterative method if beta N2 equal to 1 and beta N3 equal to 0. For normal S iterative method, if beta N2 equal to 1. For S iterative method, if beta N2 equal to 0. There is definition that we will use in this paper. Let the sequence SNI be two iterative method converging to the same fixed point S star. We say that the sequence Sn1 converges faster than Sn2 to S star if the limit of this equation are equal to 0. Next, by Sinthu Navarat and Pitya, establish some theoretical and numerical comparison results for various iterative methods, including the iterative method number 4. To approximate fixed point of the operator satisfied contractive condition number 2 in Banach space. More precisely, they prove the following theorem. The theorem 1.3, let S be a non-empty closed and convex subset of Banach space and T be a mapping satisfy the contractive condition number 2 with the fixed point S star. This theorem will be claimed that the iterative method number 4 or SP iterative method converges strongly to the fixed point S star of T faster than S iterative method by use this condition of the sequence beta and I. This result naturally gives rise to the following equation. Question is possible to approximate the fixed point of almost contraction by a simpler and faster iterative method under some mild condition or under parametric sequence beta ni. It is they aim in this paper to answer the above question in the affirmative. Thus, motivated by the above mentioned result of Belinde on theorem 1.1 and Sintunawarat and Pitya on theorem 1.3 as a complement of this work. For the development of our main result, the following lemma will be needed. The first lemma is come from Belinde on 2007. Let sigma ni be non-negative real sequence satisfy the following inequality, where sigma in this interval and limit of sigma n to equal to zero, where n go to infinity, then limit of sigma n one equal to zero when n go to infinity too. The second lemma is from Sotus and Grosseng 2008. Let sequence sigma ni be sequence of non-negative number with sigma n2 subset of open set 0, 1. And the summation of sigma n2 equal to infinity. Assume that there exists n naught in n, so that for n greater than or equal to n naught, one has this inequality. Then the following inequality holds like this. Next section is second.
Section 2, convergent analysis. In the rest of this paper, we assume that T mapping from S to S satisfy condition 2 and 3. Theorem 2.1, the iterative method sequence Sn1 in condition 4 convert to a unique fixed point S star of T. We have the following result as a direct consequence of theorem 2.1. Next theorem 2.2, let sequence Qn be defined by normal S iterative method as follow five condition where beta nt is subset of coset 0 to 1, then sequence Qn convert to a unique fixed point S star of t. Theorem 2.3, let sequence Sn1 and sequence Qn be the iterative method in condition 4 and 5. Assume that the sequence beta n1 is subset of this closed interval, satisfy this condition, then the following statements are equivalent. The first, sequence Sn1 convert to the unit fixed point S star of t. The second, sequence Qn convert to the unit fixed point S star of t. Next theorem 2.4, let sequence Sn1 and sequence Qn be the iterative method in condition 4 and 5. Assume that the sequence beta ni is subset of this interval. Satisfy the condition beta I equal to infimum of beta ni. Then sequence Qn convert to S star further than sequence Sn1, provided S no 1 equal to Q no. Next is example 1. Let beta is the number set be equipped with usual norm. S is code interval 1 to 100 and T mapping from S to S. An operator defined by Tx equal to this for all x belong to S. Query T satisfy condition 2 and 3 with delta belong to this interval. And for any epsilon greater than equal to 0, and it has a unique fixed point S star equal to 5, let Sn1 and sequence Qn be generated by condition 4 and 5. Take beta Ny equal to 1 over 2 for all n, and integral cos S01 Q0 equal to 100. You can see the back line is normal S iterative method. And next is table. This column show convert to S star of normal S iterative method. Now, fig 1 and table 1 show that normal S iterative method convert to S star faster than Mann Ishikawa norm S and SP iterative method. Section T, data dependency. In some cases, it is difficult or maybe impossible to find a fixed point of an operator. In such case, instead of computing the fixed point of that operator, we approximate it with the help of another one-word fixed point are available. In the literature, this approach is referred as data dependent. This topic has recently received a lot of attention by virtue of its promising and iterating application. Definition T.1, let T, T theta mapping from B to B, B operator. We say that T theta is approximate operator of T. If for all A belong to B and for a fixed epsilon greater than zero, we have norm of T A minus T theta A less than equal epsilon. Theorem 2, T.2, let T theta mapping from S to S be an approximate operator of T and S theta star be the fixed point of T theta. Let sequence Sn1 be the iterative method defined by condition 4 with sequence beta nt convert to 0 and sequence s tilde n1 and iterative method generated by condition 6. Suppose that sequence s tilde n1 convert to s tilde s tilde star, then we have norm of S star minus S tilde star less than equal epsilon over 1 minus delta. The next is example 2. Let S defined by this be endowed with the usual norm. Let the operator T and T tilde mapping from S to S be given by Tx and Tx tilde equal to this. Apply the mean value theorem, one can easily verify that T satisfies condition 2 with delta equal to this. It belongs to interval and for any epsilon greater than equal to 0 and it has a unique fixed point S star equal to 0. Now using well, from Mathematica 9 software packet, we have max of norm T minus T theta equal to 0.02, which implies norm of Tx minus T theta x less than equal epsilon for all x, where epsilon equal to 0.02. Hence, T theta is approximate operator of T in the sense of definition 2.1. On the other hand, the operator T tilde has a unique fixed point S star, S tilde star equal to this, and this the distance between the fixed point S star and S tilde star is 0.022 T sig 1. If we put b beta n 1 beta n 2 beta n t divide this for all n and t to the x equal to this in condition 6 then we have condition 7 like this and the table this table show convergent behavior of iterative method condition 7 it is x star theta table 2 show that iterative method of condition 7 convert to the fixed point x star theta is 0.022t61 as a matter of fact without knowing the fixed point of t theta and without computing it. We can find the following upper bound for the error in approximating s theta star by s star from the conclusion of theorem 3.2 norm of s star minus s star theta less than equal 0.04 t x 4. Next session sent by Pino.
Okay. It's the application to stable inversion. So the Fanon was relation of the structure energy of the compact mechanical engineering structure. I think for the example, metal fatigue is usually done in the experimentally in the laboratory talk at a structure injury testing SIT. In the SIT, a test specimen is a repeatedly subject to the load history that is typically representative of the normal usage load. In the quantum term, the combined system of the specimen that is a actuator, sensor, and power supply is subjected to load, repeat output tagging, and the same desolate output trajectory. The repetitive nature of the control process allows the incorporation of the learning mechanism in the process talk a control module called iterative learning control ILC. Why the ILC is a simple form, this can be
no,
อ่าล่ะน้องอยู่โอเพ่นไมโครโฟน
ผมก็ว่าอยู่เดี๋ยวนะเดี๋ยวนะโอเคได้ยินไหมครับ
Yeah, now yeah, it's okay.
โอเคSo this an application to stable inversion. The final validation of the structure energy of the compact mechanical engineering structure against, for the example, the metal fatigue is usually done experimentally.
So you know, we cannot see the slides.
Hmm?
We cannot see the slides.
ต้องกดแชร์อีกรอบหนึ่งไงพ
ี่ oh, oh. เดี๋ยวนะเดี๋ยวนะเห็นปะ are you see
no not yet
โอเคแล้วครับพ
ี่โอเคโอเคโอเค
โอเค the final variation of the structure energy of the compact mechanical engineering structure again for theExample, metal fatigue is usually done in the experimentally in the laboratory talk or structure integrity setting SIT. In the SIT, a test specimen of the repeatedly subject to the load history that is typically representative the normal usage load. In the control term, the combined system of the specimen that is a actuator, sensor, and power supply is subject to.Repeat output tagging and the same distillate output trajectory. The repetitive nature of the control process allow the incorporation of the of a learning mechanism in the process talk about a control process called the iterative learning control ILC. While the ILC is a simple form can be purely data-driven control produce, its application in SIT is almost always been inverse model based. In the fact, the use of the inverse model based approach allow the most of variable transition convert property of the achieved output trajectory, while the model originally developed in ILC in the SIT were frequency domain transfer function, the combination of the time domain model identification and analysis in the later part of the 20th century has seen the implementation of the parametric time domain model also in the model-based ILC. So the ILC in SIT setting usual than with the linear inverse model by Eskin and Hen have recently performed ILC using the inverse of the nonlinear parametric domain with the polynomial basic function. The inverse of the nonlinear parametric, this is a time domain model, was not solved until the last decade of the 20th century, when it was discovered how to solve the stability of the inverse model that results in the case of non-minimum phase system. That is a system with a non-stable slot, which often results in the case of the sample data or due to the system delay. The process obtaining the stable inversion of non-minimum phase system is referred to the stable inversion. So we consider the square nonlinear discrete time Hn of k plus 1 equal to f of xk uk and y of k equal to h of xk, where uk belong to rm, xk belong to rn, and yk belong to rm. F and h are analytic in the dia domain and k represent the discrete time step. So we let the x naught and u naught be this pair, be an equilibrium pair of the system. This is the description the multi input and multi output MIMO of the dynamic system. This equation is called the state equation, and equation 9 is called the output equation. So assuming the system have the vector relative degree, it can be inverted to the smooth inverse system. So eta of k plus 1 equal to f bar of eta k psi k, and uk equal to h bar of xk psi k, where eta and psi belong to I and hat, and psi may be determined from y. To solving the inverse system of the for the bounded solution eta and also u is related to the stable inversion of equation x and 9. So the stable inversion of nonlinear discrete time, this is the equation x and 9 was first developed by Sheng and Han at the fixed point problem talk of the Picard iterative method. So in 2015, Eskin and Hen have to implement the Mann and Ishikawa iterative method for the solution of the stable when the case of Picard failed to convert. So in this section, we use the another fixed point iterative method is the dependent of Mann and Ishikawa iterative. This is a normal S iterative method to use for the solution of the bounded inversion inverse. So we fully show how the bounded solution of the inverse system is the formula defined u of eta k psi k equal to f bar of eta k psi k minus a eta k, where a defined like this. The state dynamic system, the state dynamic system 10 is can be can restate to this system. It is a structure at the linear system. So the linear structure of the equation 12 is used to construct a bounded solution of the system. So we assuming the yd, and then we get that psi k for all k belong to n, each bounded and that the f bar of eta k psi k is bounded if psi k and xk are bounded. It can be shown that the bounded solution of the equation travel this, and also the equation 10 is equivalent to the bounded solution of eta k defined from this. For the phi k is a n by n metric, n hat n metric. So next we define the non-crucial linear operator g to represent the system travel eta equal to g u of eta psi to finding the bounded solution of the eta k of the equation travel by using the bounded solution of phi k this in the equation 13 and also equivalent to this equation like in the cost table of the inversion. This solution is obtained by the recasting at the fixed point problem. So the iterative method that may be used for the purpose include the Picard-Mann and Ishikawa iterative method. So for the example in the case of the Picard iterative method, we obtain the eta m for all m greater than or equal to 0 and eta naught equal to this. With this eta m, eta m plus 1 equal to t, eta m equal to g of u of eta m psi. This is Picard iterative. To adapt for the normal S iterative, we assuming alpha m equal to alpha, and then eta m for m greater than or equal to 0 and eta naught equal to this. This is the looks like a normal S iterative method. So the following definition will be helpful for the subsequent analysis. So we let the norm 1 and norm infinity denote by L1 and L infinity norm on n respect to, and also define norm infinity of eta equal to max of this for I denote by the component of the state vector. Next, we let eta k psi k is uniformly Lipschitz in a code S neighborhood of the equilibrium pair in the space eta psi with the positive real sequence k1 k2, and then we define norm 1 of phi equal to this. So this is a theorem. A solution eta k belong to L infinity of the system. System A exit and obtained by the normal S iterative method. If first F is the uniformly Lipschitz and S neighborhood of the equilibrium pair with the Lipschitz constant K1 K2. Next, norm 1 of phi multiply K1 less than 1 and the constant T psi k belong to the L infinity with the norm infinity of psi less than or equal to S, and the last condition, this condition hold, then the eta k belong to L infinity is about the solution of the equation A, and then this select the reference. Thank you for your attention.
First, you back to your main result.
Main result.
What is the idea you find this algorithm from where?
this algorithm is normal H. The normal H will defined by Sahu in 2000, maybe 11. But in this paper, they would like to show that the normal H iterative method convert faster than Sinthu Navarat and Pitya. So, that Sinthu Navarat and Pitya, they show that in the 2016, this iterative method convert faster than normal H by using many conditions like this. But in this paper show that normal H iterative method convert faster than Sinthu Navarat and Pitya by using one condition. That's it, this condition, beta I, if imam of beta I is positive.
Okay, I saw one paper, your application to data,
data dependent.
See, in the look like previous paper, right? But this example, the same application for your previous paper by Gollwood.
Oh.
But there are different kind of algorithm.
Algorithm, yeah.
But then I mean example is are the same.
This is maybe in this paper we will only study, but we will try to find another fixed point theorem and then use for the application to the stable equation, but also to image recovery, but just only study.
But not this you are not finished yet, right?
Yet.
What is some application of this part?
This is a stable inversion. Maybe they find the bounded solution of this system. This system is called a supernal linear decrease. This time is a stable inversion.
Okay. We have some another question from audience, from participant. Oh, I saw many. Oh, 16. Hello, everybody. We have.
Yeah, I have question.
Okay, at least you can.
Okay. To you.
Yeah.
Your system 8 and 9.
Yeah.
The dynamical system.
Yeah.
Is MIMO, right?
Hmm? Yeah. MIMO.
MIMO, that is multiple input, multiple output.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you know in dynamical system, we have MIMO and CISO. You know CISO?
I don't know CISO. It just
that is single input. Mm. No, single input, single output.
Mm. Oh, single input with output.
Yes. So what is the reason behind to take this MIMO system, the dynamical system in a MIMO setting, that is the multiple output and multiple input?
The Again.
What I mean is that in our case, you consider the MIMO case. That is the multiple input, multiple output. And there is another kind of dynamical system that is a single input, single output, that is CISO. So what is the techniques behind of choosing this MIMO system?
But I don't use the CISO, right?
Yeah.
But I'm not sure. I just follow from them. Maybe I will study more for the stable inversion.
What okay. Again, you didn't define what is M and R. And what happened if M is equals, is this M equals to N or M and N, they are distinct, different. So you didn't define M and N. So I think you're supposed to define M and N.
Oh.
So is their numbers. Yeah.
Okay.
You see? In equation 8 and 9.
This is M and N here. Right.
Yeah.
Oh. Maybe I think
finite maybe dimension. Type in.
Yeah.
Again, you can go back to equation number 6.
Number 6.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So what is beta N2? You only define beta N3. You didn't define beta N and beta N1, but what is beta N2?
Oh.
And beta N1.
God, you need to help me. God help you.
Full screen.
Beta
N1 and beta N2.
Uh-huh.
You only define
mm-hmm.
beta N3, the limit of beta N3 goes to zero. I'm confused. What is beta N?
I think beta N.
Oh, I saw in the photo paper. So,
get that in.
So you define from here. Yeah. Eta in of I for belong to this box for I equal to 1, 2, and T. It's a belong to the Cauchy interval 0, 1.
Okay, this is just my observations.
Thank you.
But again, why your slide is more than 15?
Yeah, we have
almost 40 something.
We have 3%. We give 15.
Oh, so it's allowed for presentation. Each person 15.
Yeah. If you have one person, you need to have 15. Okay,
thank you.
Another question? Ian,
ได้ย
ิน
ครับเมื่อถามต้องไดนามิกหน่อยอ่ะมันรีเควสถามเหรอถ้าจะไปทำว่าถามต้องเสร็จภายในเวลาเท่าไหร่อะไรเงี้ยพอรู้ไหมอย่างนี้ถ้าจะภายใน
อันนี้ยังไม่รู้ครับ
เผื่อมันจะเป็นแบบอาจารย์ปฏิภาณอ่ะที่ต้องการให้เสร็จภายในกี่ไมโครเซกก็ไม่รู้จำไม่ได้ละเพราะว่าไดนามิกมันต้องทำนะมัน ตามล็อกของมันถ้ามันมีล็อกเวลาไหมแค่นี้แหละ
ครับผม
ระวังเรื่องเดิน
เดี๋ยวผมไปเช็คอีกทีแต่มันมีตัวอย่างอยู่ครับพอดีผมอ่านตัวอย่างยังไม่เข้าใจเมื่อเรามาแค่ทฤษฎีครับ
เหรอ
ครับ
มันยังไม่ได้ลองทำซิมูเลตอะไรให้ดูใช่ไหม
ครับ
มันไม่รู้ถามไหมถามรู้เหมือนกัน
Pete, finish your mini project in the end of this semester because I must be evaluated. Or I ask head of lab for conclusion or is a like proceeding of seminar. Not here, the head of lab.
อยู่ครับอาจารย์ครับ
โอเค no have some format look like last semester
ครับ
you change it this semester in the cover
ครับ
no present format to every group โอเคไปนอนลิฟต์มีใครมีอะไรอีกไหม
สี่ครับเรียบร้อยนะครับเจอกันพรุ่งนี้ครับ
พรุ่งนี้ใช่ไหมหนง
ครับ
ไว้
see you
tomorrow เรียบร้อยก่อน
ครับ
ก่อนทามแล้วก็ตอนเช้ามันมีด็อกเตอร์นอร์วิลพรีเซนต์ tomorrow 11 a.m.Please attend, Dr. Noor.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I noted the time.
Yeah.
11 a.m. Thailand time?
Yes.
11 a.m.
Okay. What is the topic?
I will send you up.
You can send it here. Yeah. Or in the... He suggest Dr. Noor how to do that. In our group.
Okay.Now at this time.
Oh, you say me on the 3rd of April?
No, at this time, I send you my slides and my topic.
I not see. You send me by email or in here?
Can I send now?
Yes, you can send or you can put
through emails.
No, in this group, in Microsoft team.
Yes. You can put in here, in our FitQuiet group in here. Look like somebody is put in here, in the slide.
Okay, sir.
Hello, Titi.
Titi. เพื่อนถามหา
I'm fine.
Sure.
What?
ไม่ใช่แล้วไม่ใช่แล้ว
What happened with your beer?No going out.
Did you know going out?
He มีลูกแล้วเหรอเนี่ย
Okay. I said no going out, Pipi.
ต้องใส่หมดเล็ก
ก่อน Not going out.
Okay. See you.
Okay, see you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, you can
bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
You can please cut with the PP for your work, your group.
Yes.
Yes.